Hello, Jacob here again. Today being episode number 43 of Enter the Gungeon. So in this episode we're going to try and beat the secret chamber on chamber 2 again, the temple. Because we tried that in the last episode and we died on the boss. We're also going to try and make it to the end of the game with the pilot. So obviously we've killed the past of the marine. So we need to try and kill the past for these other three characters as well. So we'll have a go with the pilot to start with. So going in, I'm going to head out chamber 1, return for the boss fight and the obelisk, and then we'll on chamber 2 I'll edit that out and I'll return for the temple. Just because it's a bit of a waste of time showing you chamber 1 and 2 really. So I'll be back soon. Okay, I'm back. So, there's two... let's go find another key first. There's a brown chest over there, but I failed to open it. So, we'll just buy a key. And we'll open up the little trap door that's over here. So, these blue chests, we just have to try and lockpick one of them. Because there are no more keys. Failed. We're going to fight the boss, and then I'll come back for the other one after the boss. Because by the time we kill the boss, our lockpick would have recharged. So let's go in here and try and get the health upgrade, hopefully. Okay, it's the twins. So these guys are the easiest to kill. I'm just going to take a little while to kill them with the pistol here. Oh shit, I get hit there. It's hard to say, I'm going to concentrate on beating these guys, but I took a hit, so... I'm just kind of commentating, I guess, like normal. Killing these guys with the pistol is a bit irritating, really. Okay. He's almost got one of them. Let's take out these two over here. Always going to take out the little ones. Because they can be a bit of a thorn in your side if you kind of let them live. And they will just keep spawning in as well. It's not going great. Let's try and kill this one. Come on. Get out of here. You almost got this one. One more shot. There we go. Nice. Two more shots. Let's take out this one. So a bit low on health here, which is not good. But we should be alright, hopefully. Hopefully we get a good reward. And hopefully we get some heals from beating this guy. So I'll set it up nicely for the obelisk, whatever it's been called, something like that. This is the problem using the pistol, is that the fight kind of drags on so long that it kind of becomes inevitable that you get hit at some point. Like, if we had a better weapon, these guys would have been dead a long time ago. I took another hit there. We got him, though. There we go. Now, we've got some health back. That's good. Oh, the guitar. It's not a great weapon, the guitar, but not much we can do about that. Let's go try and open this chest. That's three chests in a row. Not quite my record, though. My record is eight chests in a row that I failed. That was quite something that happened. I mentioned it in a previous episode. Yeah, eight chests in a row failed, and I opened at number 9 with the lockpick, and then number 10 failed as well. That was just pretty ridiculous, actually, when that happened. So we have to clear this now, using the pistol. Let's get some distance on these guys. A shit ton of shotgun is in here, which I'm not really a fan of. There's one down. Oh great, there's more spawning in now. Let's take out this poop. Come on. Oh, come on. There we go, there's another one down. Oh shit. Let's get closer to this guy. Oh, we got him, nice. Whew, that was a hell of a room there. Hell of a start. Okay, nice easy bulletkin to kick off in the second room here. Man, it's pretty amazing that we didn't take a hit there. That was quite the room. So all we have to do is make it to the boss with some decent health, because the boss on this floor is pretty easy. We've shown him off a couple of times, but oh shit, he's basically just a bastard bullet sponge, basically. The blobby lord. Let's try and use this cover over here to our advantage. Ooh, let's get down here. Down he goes. Nice. Okay. Thinning the herd a little bit here. Go, nice. Any more? Got some more. Okay, he's not a problem. These guys are quite easy to kill. They're quite low health enemies, the Poopulons. They're just a bit irritating. Their bullet pattern's quite irritating, but they're pretty weak in terms of health. So wait for him to finish first before you go around the corner. There we go. I'm kind of curious as to if that kind of little nugget does anything. Sometimes when you kill the poops, like a little kind of nugget stays behind, but it didn't seem to actually do anything, from what I can tell. Let's put some poison down here. That'll help us out a bit. Oh, shit. Ah, oh, I got stuck in the wall. There's one down. Okay, found the shopkeeper. Okay, nice big room. The bigger the room, the kind of easier it is to deal with these kind of shotgunners. The obelette, not really the theme, but a lot of shotgunners do pop up on this floor here. Like a hell of a lot of shotgunners. But obviously, the bigger the room, the easier it is to kind of deal with the kind of number of shotgunners you're dealing with. Because think of the shotgunners, the further you are away from them, the more shotgun spreads out. It kind of makes it just a bit easier to avoid their shots, really. Let's hit this guy out. Let's keep our distance on this guy. So just shoot out a lot of stuff. As you can see. Ah, nice ammo. That's just useless for us. Okay, we need a key to go in here. And that's a bit of a problem, because we might need a key to get to the crest. The crest is sometimes behind a locked door. Also, we need the crest to put on the altar, which gains access to the secret chamber on chamber 2. So, hopefully find a key, because I don't want to risk losing a lockpick to get in there. Because we also might fail, which is not good. These are the blobs. Okay, a blue chest. We're probably gonna have to lockpick it. Let's carry on clearing the rooms here. But as you can see here, dodging this guy's shots is a bit more tricky in these kind of more confined spaces. Got a grenade. Okay. Shouldn't be too off the exit now, I don't think. Got some cubes here. Let's use these kind of little pillars as cover. There we go. Got a near cube. I got the shotgun there. And that's it, is it? Yep, nice. Oh, okay. So let's try and get across here without taking a hit if we can. Ooh! Ah! Fucked it up there. Thought I could get across just in time there, but not quite. So the low amount of health is a bit worrying, although I am hoping to beat the next boss without taking a hit, hopefully. to kind of solve some of our problems we've got here. We're going to need help as well because the temple is quite tricky. The temple that's going to come up later. We made it there before. Obviously, I died on the boss, but it's some pretty tough enemies in that temple. Quite a lot of the kind of cursed enemies. I guess you could call them, or kind of demon kind of variants. I don't really know what they're called, but kind of big red guys. A lot of those guys. Oh, blank. Okay, I'd rather have a key, but that'll have to do. Yeah, well, I'll start to kind of rack up some blanks, though. Got 5 blanks, that's quite handy. Oh! Ooh. Nice. Got another one. Okay, this is going to go to the chest. Let's find out what the chest is, I guess. Okay, this room. This is not too bad. You basically just have to kind of rush across. Oh shit, we're kind of in trouble here. Ah, balls, fuck that. Well, I'm actually dead. Wow, okay. Well, let's have another go. Not a great start. I think filling those 3 chests kind of messes up a bit. So I'll come back once I've cleared the chamber again. Okay, I'm back here. So let's head into the boss fight. I failed 2 more lockpick attempts, which is... I think that's like 5 in a row now we failed. So that's something. I have to check that when I'm editing the episode to see just how many we have failed, but I think it's 5 now we failed. So we could go for a new record here. We've only got to do 4 more for a record, I guess. Ooh. So we're trying to beat this guy, take a hit if we can. The Bullet King's not ideal, because he is the toughest Chamber 1 boss, I feel, anyway. Oh, balls. This bit always catches me. Yeah, that's the bit that always catches me. That bit there. Usually, anyway. Ah. The rest of it's not too bad. Just that bit. This bit here, where he shoots out like those bullets above his head. That bit always gets me. If we had a better weapon, this would be a lot easier. Maybe we should have a go at with the hunter. Seeing as the hunter obviously starts with the crossbow, and the compass has a shotgun, which I guess is better than the pilot's kind of pistol, I guess. But I'm going to go for the pistol just so I can still try to open chests. Obviously, we're going to use 2 keys to open up the trapdoor, I guess. We can still kind of try and have a go opening chests with our lockpick, obviously. You got him anyway. Okay, well, I've got a bit of a rubbish reward. The charge shot, not a very good weapon, really. Let's have a go opening the screen chest over here. It's a bit annoying as well, because there's some health over here by the locked door. I tried to obviously get in there, and I just failed. So let's see if we can fail lock number 6. Oh, there we go, that's 6 in a row. We failed. So, yeah, that's nice. Let's see if we can get 3 more of those. If we get 2 more, I can actually use that episode title that I was thinking of using a couple of episodes back. I've said it before in a previous episode, but when I failed those 8 chests in a row, I wasn't actually recording at the time. And obviously, I came up with a really good video title as well during that time, but obviously, I wasn't recording, so I couldn't really use the title I wanted to. But I think we're on 6 now, so if we fail 2 more, I can use that title, which would be nice. I'm still kind of curious what the chance is. Like, usually it's about kind of, I think, a third of the time you fail, but I think sometimes you just get really unlucky and just fail like loads of times sometimes. But I guess that's just kind of how the kind of RNG kind of works sometimes, I guess. It's kind of like in Hearthstone, you can kind of blame the game, but sometimes that's just kind of what happens, really, so you just get really, really unlucky. Yeah, okay, so let's clear these rooms. Nothing too difficult so far. Not too pleased to see these bats, bat down here, because the bats are, the big bat is quite annoying, especially if you have to fight more than one as well. Not too bad on their own. Okay, one of these rooms. Oh, damn, I fucking fell off the bloody side of the platform. Okay, let's not do that again. This is what I was kind of talking about on the last one, about kind of confined spaces. Like, fighting on these kind of narrow platforms does make things a lot more difficult than it kind of really should be. We'll have to dodge over here. Oh, we can't make... Ah, fuck. Too far to dodge. Wow. What a... it's kind of a shitty start to the episode. We'll carry on, though. We already have one heart, half a heart here. We've got a key, though. But, this might be another short little run here, by the looks of it. In a more sense, to just scrap the episode and just start again. It's been so poor, but we'll carry on, because, I mean, you can always come back in this game. It's usually never kind of too late to kind of make a comeback, usually. You never know, the game might kind of throw you a bone and throw some, like, a free bit of health or, like, a really good weapon or something. Yeah, a green chest. Let's try and lockpick it. Oh, man, that's... Pretty sure that's seven in a row. Ooh, we're kind of in trouble here. Ooh, we made it out. Oh, we died. Well, let's start again. Okay, I'll be back soon, once I've cleared the floor. Okay, I'm back. So, there's a green chest down here, and I tried to lockpick and I failed. So I think that's... Is that number 8? I've lost count, but I think that's like number 7 or 8. But I'll pick this brown chest up here. So we've got the... Ooh, we've got the mailbox. That's good, because the shop's got the elephant gun in it. And I was thinking that if I don't get a good weapon, I'll just buy the elephant gun. But the mailbox is a pretty decent little weapon, so we're going to go to the boss fight here. It's these two again. So as you can see here... Oh, we took a hit. Whoops. As you can see here, the mailbox does a lot more damage compared to our basic pistol. So these guys are going to be a lot easier to kill now. Almost got one already. Nice, one down. Not going to be the health upgrade. I think I got stuck on the door there. I hate getting stuck on the door in this game so much. So irritating. Okay, almost got him. Hope we get a decent reward, hopefully. Nice. Oh, the sniper rifle, that's alright. Sniper rifle's a pretty decent weapon. Nothing, not amazing, but decent. We can use that on the next floor. So that's everything on this floor, I think. Yeah, we could buy a key. We did get a free key on the floor. Oh, we haven't got a key. Okay, well, let's just head in then, I guess. Good job we got that free key. Okay, let's go in. Hopefully this goes better than the last two attempts, because the last two attempts were pretty disastrous, but I think having the sniper rifle is going to make it a lot easier. So we're not going to use the... We'll probably use the mailbox in the next boss. Probably a mixture of mailbox and pistol, I think. I'm not going to use the sniper rifle just because it's going to be a waste of ammo because he's got so much bloody health, the Blobulon. He wants some snipers. Pretty easy start. Hide around the corner. There we go. Nice. Got him. Any more? More snipers. That's one of these bastard green ones. Take this guy out quick. This green. Oh, he killed himself. Nice. Yeah, the green ones are a bit. The ones with the kind of green laser sights are a bit of a pain to deal with. Oh, we got one of these guys. Let's throw a few sniper shots at him. There we go. Nice. Nice. And we've got a blank. Well, add some ammo. Nice. Oh shit! I refilled the sniper, but I should have refilled the. Oh shit! I should have refilled the mailbox. Is what I should have done. Let's take a few of these guys out. As for the snipers, it does the shots do kind of penetrate, so we can kind of line these guys up for kind of multi kind of shot. It does make things a lot easier. Man, I wish I had refilled that mailbox. That was a bit of a mistake there on my part. I just saw the ammo just on automatically kind of refilled my sniper, without really kind of thinking. Oh shit. Oh, let's try and take this guy out quick. Got him, nice. Always take him out first. Otherwise you'll be in here forever, kind of fighting these guys. Throw some fire down. No, didn't really work. There we go. Ooh, close. I can't believe I took a hit on those bullet twins. That was bullshit. Well, it wasn't really bullshit. It's my own fault. I got stuck on the door, I think. Okay, let's take the poop out first, because he's a bit of a pain. There we go. Any poison? That's good. Get some bulletkin. Easy enough to deal with. Found the shopkeeper nice and early, which is good. Ooh, he's stuck. Ah, nice key. Good. So we can use that to go into that crest if we need it. Okay, he's got keys. Nothing really worth buying. The Phoenix is not a great weapon. Okay, let's carry on. Don't miss anything? Nope. Okay, let's carry on. We've got lots of money, which is good. So we can pretty much buy anything we want. Ah, we can't dodge across this gap here, because I did try it last time, and obviously it killed me. Nice. Yeah, you see the sniper's very, very useful to have, just because it's just nice to have that kind of very powerful, kind of accurate kind of shot. She's still a lockpick, but it failed again. So I think that's 8 out of 9 chests we failed. That's kind of bad. I have to count them when I go to kind of edit this episode, but I'm pretty sure that's the 8th chest we failed out of 9 chests, I think. Ah, fuck. Wasn't paying attention there. Oh shit. Get out of here. Those guys are a bit irritating just because the way they kind of have that kind of split shot can kind of throw you off sometimes. You are kind of expecting a bullet to kind of come in a straight line towards you. Obviously, those guys don't normally have to pop up to a chamber 5, so it is quite a late game enemy, that guy. Okay, let's use a sniper here. Let's get these shotgunners quick, can. There we go, nice. Ooh, shit. Ooh, that's close. If he had kind of fired there, he probably would have taken a hit. I'm just going to go back here first, just because I don't want to get hit getting across there. Because bullets do stick around for a while. Ah, nice. Found the crest. We'll come back to this after you beat the boss. Did he have any armor, the shopkeeper? No. Because I'm kind of curious if you pick up the crest and then you pick up some armor after picking up the crest, does the armor get used up before the crest? It would be handy if it worked that way. Oh shit! I have to go across here again now. So that would be a way to kind of. Because obviously you need to get the crest and then make it to the alt without taking a hit. But if you could kind of stack up a couple of bits of armor after picking up the crest, it would kind of make things a bit easier. Okay, let's go up here. We shouldn't be too... I don't know, actually. It's quite a long chamber, this one. So we should... There's probably a couple more rooms to go before the kind of boss. We still got to find another chest as well. We need a sniper to take out the shotgunners. So you want to take out the shotgunners fairly quick, because they can cause a bit of some problems for us. There's blobs. There we go. Try and kill it. Take out the poop. There we go, we got him. Nice. Take out the sniper. Okay, so back to the pistol now. So make things nice and easy. Try not to take any kind of risks. Okay, well, we should kind of use the pistol there, because these guys... We've got plenty of room to fight these guys. They shouldn't cause too much problem for us. These big, big guys. Okay, let's get a bit closer so we can get some shots in on them. Try by and cover. This one's got the lowest health, so let's try to take him out first. Let's shoot again. That's one down. Ooh, shit. Fire. Come on. There we go. There we go. Got him. Oh, nice ammo. Let's refill the mailbox. There we go. Didn't make that mistake twice, luckily. So we found the other chests up here. So let's have a look. I think this is chest number 10. So let's see if we can go 9 for 10. Well, I really want to go 8 for 10 just so I can call the episode what I want to call it. We'll shoot the circuit. Oh shit, I didn't mean to do that. I was going to kick the poison barrel towards him and then shoot it, but didn't quite get a plan there. Shoot off a sniper shot here. There we go. I think it's going to hit all of them. But I think once it penetrates once, the second target hits, I think takes less damage, I think, from the sniper. Seems that way. Let's get a sniper back out. There we go. Now sniper and pistol. There we go. Okay, let's kill a couple of shotgunners. No, there we go. The auto aim was targeting the wrong enemy, annoyingly. The auto aim in the game is a little bit irritating at times. So the chest's actually this way. Like, I've noticed, the more I play, the more I've kind of noticed how the kind of auto aim works. It does. Sometimes it does kind of lock on to the wrong enemy sometimes. Like, so most of the time, you can actually notice that the game even has auto aim, but when you do kind of notice it, it is a little bit jarring when you do kind of notice it. So sometimes you're kind of snap on to a target, and it kind of becomes really kind of noticeable. Okay, what's up? Let's carry on. Say what's up here. We know what's up here. It's just going to be rooms of enemies. And there's going to be a chest at the end. Yep, nice. One more room. Let's take the sniper shotguns out first. Ooh. Oh, ah, fuck. I fell in the bloody... Ugh. Oh, I fell in again. Oh, no. Not a great start. Well, not a great. Just not great in general, really. That was pretty bad on my part. Things are going better than they did the last two runs, though. We actually made it to the boss this time. Okay, what's this chest here then? We could use a key to open it. Yeah, it's a green one. We'll try and lockpick it. Oh, failed. I think that's 9 out of 10 chests we failed now. Okay, let's use the mailbox here. So, the mailbox is going to make this fight go a bit quicker, because usually I fight with using the pistol, usually. It takes kind of ages to kill him. Well, he's almost down to half health, that's good. Okay, he's going to do this big thing, and we're going to split this up into multiple blobs. Ooh, almost took a hit there. Almost. Coming back to life, there we go. So hopefully these guys, these kind of extra bosses, hopefully they give you mass rounds for picking them out taking hits. Hopefully. Let's get away from him. We can use a blank if we need to. He's almost dead. Almost dead. Yeah, and we got him. Nice. So do you get a mass round for that? Ooh. Okay, so you don't actually get mass rounds for killing his boss without taking the hit, annoyingly. That's a bit harsh. I guess it kind of makes sense, because you obviously could beat the chamber one boss, come down here, beat this guy, and then you could get two hearts and one chamber. So I guess I kind of get it, but I don't know, it's a bit harsh in my opinion. Let's go back and get the crest. Nothing worth munching, so we're just going to hang on to our weapons. Oh shit, let's not go that way. Let's go this way. Just don't, risk taking a hit. I mean, I think a better way for that to work would be if you, maybe if you fail on the Chamber 1 boss, maybe kind of give you a chance to get a master round on this boss. But if you, obviously if you beat the first boss and get the master round, maybe then you could kind of, you know, not give us a health upgrade for beating this boss. Oh shit, I made a mistake there. I should have got the crest first then, because the boss dropped some armor. So what I should have done there is actually got the crest. No, got the crest first, then the armor. So I actually made a mistake there. Hopefully that doesn't come back to bite us in the ass. Let's head back to the shopkeeper briefly. I think he has some health, so we might buy some health off him. He's got loads of money. Okay, he's got a key. Half a heart. We're fine. We've already got a key, so we don't need another key, really. Yeah, it's kind of annoying there, because I did want to test my theory of whether how you can kind of stack the armor into your favor with the crest. Obviously now we need to make it to the ult without taking a hit. Probably just use the sniper rifle here. I really don't want to take a hit now. That would be not good. Okay. Let's get stuck in. Oh shit. Oh, I thought I was going to take a hit there, but we didn't, luckily. Use a couple of sniper shots here. Okay, oh, I was going to blow the chest up there, of the barrel, I mean. I was hoping he was going to stand still so I could shoot the barrel. But obviously not. Okay, I've got to try and find the altar quick. Okay, I've got some snipers here. Out. Only one sniper though, so it shouldn't be too bad. Then we fire for a shot, there we go. Got him. There we go, it's him down. Come out. Nice. We're doing alright so far. Oh shit, that's not good. Let's take him out. Ugh. Don't take any risks here. No point taking the risks there. Just take him out as quick as we can. Out of the way, there we go. Nice. Ah, ammo. We could probably refill the sniper, because we've still got quite a bit of mailbox ammo, but the sniper's starting to get a bit low. So let's refill the sniper. Okay, we've got some more snipers. Oh, there we go. Oh nice, the sniper's gone out to one shot, that's good. Okay, lead main, let's keep our distance. There we go, got him nice and quick. Oh! Ooh. Nice. Just take our time. There we go, take him out, get that guy out, nice. Okay, so what's in here? Oh, shoot too. That's good, I suppose. We can get the those two will fully heal you. Doesn't mean waste that money buying that heart on the last floor. That's okay. Barrels, not very good. That's okay. Ah, nice, made it. Okay, so let's place that on the altar. We'll go fight the boss before we go in. Because we may as well, because we've got a full heal. Oh, I just realised. The crest. We put the crest on there, but we didn't lose the armour. We still got two armour. We didn't pick up any other armour, did we? I don't think so. So that's good to know. So I did think that once you put the crest on the altar, you'd lose the armour, but I guess not. It's well worth fighting all the bosses that you come across, just because obviously you can get the health upgrade, and obviously you also get reward for every boss you fight as well. So there's really not much reason not to kind of fight every boss, really. Especially that health upgrade. We may as well. If you fight the boss and take a load of damage, we can just heal up anyway. Nice. Ah, key. Good. Let's try and find some chests. We can finally start opening chests again now, which is good. Hopefully, we've come across some good chests. More enemies, shotgunners. Ah, balls. Yeah, fighting shotgunners in these kind of smaller rooms is a bit of a pain sometimes. So sometimes you can kind of get cornered like that. It's one of these rooms. Probably best just to go for the middle here. Oh, well, so much for that idea. Okay, blue chest. Let's use a key. Ooh, the laser sight gives you what's it do again? Increases accuracy. So our shots have a bit less of a spread on them now. We come back to the entrance here, annoyingly. Okay, so make our way to the left over here. Got loads of money, which is good, which means that you can buy lots of health and armor in the shop if you need to. We've got quite a few weapons as well, so we're doing alright at the moment. I found the exit. Let's go find the other chest before we go in. So this will make having these extra chambers will kind of make making it to the shortcut a bit easier, because for the shortcut we do need to open up the next part of the shortcut, we need to get 6 keys. I think it was like 300 money, I think it was. Having these extra rooms we can go into is going to make that a bit easier. Oh, I am going to do it off screen at some point. I'm not going to bother recording that just because it's going to be a bit boring to watch, I think. So we've got another key. Oh nice, let's open up this one as well. The origami, not that great a weapon, in my opinion. So what I kind of mean about the chest is that, like, even though it was a blue chest, and blue chest is quite a good chest, you don't always get something good out of the blue chest, and you don't always get something good out of the kind of red and black chest either. But I guess it does kind of depend on your kind of play style, I guess, to a certain degree. But yeah, I mean, not really a fan of the origami, to be honest. Maybe it's really good. Maybe some people are really good at using it. Just doesn't suit my kind of playstyle. I don't know. Except this little guy. Ah, balls took a hit there. We can heal, so it's all right. I came in here really to get the kind of health upgrade. Really, this guy would be so much easier if we didn't shoot out these annoying little minions. The little minions are what make this fight kind of a bit tricky. If it wasn't for that, this guy would be really, really easy to beat. We're actually almost out of mailbox ammo, annoyingly. almost down. There we go, got him. So let's get our health and armour. Now we've got a bit of a rubbish reward. Got the Cog of Battle, which I'm not really a fan of. Funny, obviously you can get a bit of a faster reload using it, but I don't know, I'm not really a fan of that item, to be honest. Like, I think it is useful for certain weapons that have a kind of really, really long reload, like the RPG, it might be useful, but for most weapons it's not really that useful, really. So let's get healed. These two are going to heal us. It's a half a heart for free, so it's alright. Shopkeeper's not got nothing worth buying, I don't think. You could buy a key. We've already got two keys, so... you could buy the barrel. It's not that great a weapon. Do we buy the key? Yeah, okay, let's buy a key. So let's head to the... Enter the temple. Probably stick with the sniper rifle again. I might use the Luxon cannon on the next boss. So let's head in. So we died here last time on the boss. The boss is it's the Bullet King again, like an undead version of him. And we actually died to him in about 10 seconds. Because we came out there with like really, really low health. Now this chamber is quite tricky because there's some pretty hard enemies do kind of pop up here. Try and kill these Bulletkin first. It's not like impossible, but I don't know. It is quite difficult, this chamber I found last time. Get the sniper out for a little bit. Nice. Fire over here. Pick out the ghost. Hopefully that'll be the end of the room. There's not any more going to spawn in. Nice. Okay. So, pretty good start. Oh! Ooh, got a bit close to him there. Nice. Let's come down here. Try and flank these guys a little bit. More just kind of leave the cube till last, I guess. Rather than kind of flanking, because he's kind of slow anyway. Use the pistol as much as we can. So we want to save our sniper ammo if we can. Okay, another one of these. These guys are a bit irritating, but they're not too bad. Well, the problem with these guys, they're fine on their own. They're really irritating when there's like a bunch of other enemies kind of hunting you down, and you've got this kind of annoying blob chasing you who kind of explodes into like a million bullets when he dies. Okay, green chest. We're not going to use two keys to open it, but we'll try and lockpick. Okay. I might come back for that later. We'll see how we do with keys, because the green chest is not... We generally don't get great items with the green chest, but we might open it. We'll have a go at lockpicking it, obviously, at least. We'll save the keys for now. But I definitely wasn't going to use two keys there to open that green chest, because that's just a waste of a key. Waste of two keys, really. So we're having a pretty easy time so far. Nothing too bad. These Bulletkin with the kind of hats on are a little bit annoying. They're a bit tougher than your kind of typical Bulletkin. Take a bit more of a beating. Okay, so these are undead. This shouldn't be too hard of a room. These guys are generally pretty weak anyway. Hopefully the fire does a bit of work for us. Oh, there's quite a few of them. Okay, is that it? Or any more? That's it. Yeah, nice and easy, just like I thought it would be. So things are going pretty well for us so far. Probably using the accurate reload a bit more. Ah, another one of these rooms. Ooh, shit. Got bounced about there. Like a really pinball. I tried to dodge out of the way, but I just ended up getting kind of bounced around. Oh, another green chest, okay. So again, we'll come back later. We haven't come across any kind of red or black chest yet, annoyingly. Probably sniping around at this guy. Try to take him out quick. Nice. Got these annoying guys. I have actually got a really, another really good title for another episode. I'm saving it for the kind of right opportunity, but yeah, I've got another good title lined up about this kind of bulletkin with the, like this kind of Cult of the Dead bulletkin. I got a good title for that at some point. We'll buy the armor. I don't think we'll buy the armor of Thorns because it's not that good, really. So we're probably not that too far off the exit now, to be honest. Take out this bulletkin first. Take out that guy, nice. I think the active reload, the cog of battle that you got, it gives us active reload. I think it would be a lot better. It's obviously in Gears of War, when you active reload you get a damage boost, but I'm pretty sure in this game there's no damage boost for active reloading. I think you just, it's just a quicker reload. It would actually make the item a lot better if you got like a damage boost from it. But I don't think that's how it works. Cause like I said, it's just a slightly faster reload, which isn't actually that useful really. Like a damage boost as well would actually make it a lot more useful. I'd probably you know, actually use it a bit more. The problem with the cog of battle is even when I do get it, I don't really use it. That's kind of the biggest problem really, is I don't really kind of remember to active reload. Because the problem is you kind of go through so much of the game just reloading normally that you don't kind of remember to kind of use the active reload when you got it. That's the problem. Oh nice, more health. Good. Oh, here we go. One of these cursed... You do see these kind of cursed enemies pop up on this chamber sometimes. And the cursed gunlets are a bit of a pain because they take a hell of a beating, these cursed ones. They really, really take a beating, these ones. Luckily though, he's obviously just as easy to kill. Just takes a long time to kill. Ah shit, we walked right into him there. There we go. Oh, hello poop. I was quite surprised to see him pop up here. Okay, let's go see what the other chest is. Now we've got so much money. Oh, the exit, okay. So hopefully we can beat this next boss, because I'm not entirely sure what to expect, other than obviously the kind of Bullet King. It's the Bullet King again, but he is a little bit different. It's not just a rehash completely. Okay, another cursed enemy. We'll save him for last. I think they are a little bit faster than the normal ones as well. Could be. Seems to move a bit faster. Oh, hello. Let's take this guy out. There we go, down he goes. The sniper is quite handy to have around. Is that it? Oh, got some more. Nice. Oh, health. Good. We've got loads of health we can go back and get if we need to. Throw a grenade right at us there. Cheeky. I got this blob. So saying it's quite hard, it's actually not been very difficult. Like, last time I came here I had a lot of trouble, but it's actually a lot easier this time. I think just because I got better weapons, I think. So I think last time I didn't have any decent weapons. Okay, another green chest. Let's try and lockpick one of them. Okay, failed that one. I think I'll lockpick, try and pick up, because I did that because lockpick obviously needs to recharge, so we're going to lockpick one, go into the boss and try and recharge our lockpick, and then we'll have a go lockpicking another one, I think. Okay, let's head in. We'll use the Luxon Cannon. Pretty much out of mailbox ammo. Luxon Cannon. Probably use the Origani a little bit as well. Okay. Wait, that doesn't do much damage to him. Wow, this didn't really not do damage at all, to be honest. Ah, fuck. Piss off. Oh, fuck. Okay, we're down to... pretty getting pretty low already. Oh, shit. We're down to one hit here. Okay, well, oh, we're dead. Well, the Luxon Cannon was rubbish. Barely touched him. He's pretty... he's kind of hard, I guess, but I don't know. I just don't know his patterns is a problem. Should we do another run, or should we call that an episode? I mean, I've been playing for a while, but I'm going to edit quite a lot of it out, so... maybe we'll have one more go. One thing I'm kind of tempted to do is... no, we haven't done it yet, but I haven't opened up Chamber 5 shortcut yet. One thing I'm tempted to do is to get the kind of gun upgrade from that woman. And then you can take the shortcut to Chamber 5 and go straight to the boss. That'd be one way to kind of see the kind of extra bosses quite quickly. Man, we died so quick to that guy. My own fault, of course. Let's talk to this guy over here. Okay. Oh, one thing I forgot to mention is this guy over here. Talked to him off camera, so he's actually got a chain on his helmet now, so he can't kick it down anymore. But I talked to him, and he talked about me kicking his helmet off, and he gave me a new item. It was a helmet. I can't remember what it's called now. It's like the... where is it? Probably won't be able to find it. Still don't know what this coin does. Oh, here we go, the blast helmet. Yeah, he gave us that. Number 2. Apparently we've had that item before, but I don't remember having that. I don't remember having that item. Huh, weird. Boost stats when alone. I don't remember ever picking that one up. Apparently we have though, apparently. Coolant. Busted television. There's still quite a lot of items we haven't got yet. You know what? We'll just call it an episode, I think. And I'll return for episode number 44. So I've been Jacob. This has been Enter the Gungeon. I'll see you in episode number 44. You can leave me a like, comment, or a dislike. And I'll see you in the next episode. So bye for now. Bye.